Hey guys, Amber from the Vault here, back with more Horizon Zero Dawn. Now, this game is absolutely fantastic. If you're an Xbox or a PC player, it might be time to, you know, just head over to somebody's house who's got a PS4 and play this one. But you're in for a ride, because it's 30 to 60 hours long. So I apologize that you guys can't play it. I have to say, if you are an Xbox or a PC player, I apologize to you guys for how amazing this game looks. And so far, the gameplay is awesome. I hope that we keep seeing stuff like this. I can't say as though I want it to be an exclusive, but I hope that we keep seeing games like this. It is absolutely gorgeous. Now, I have been talking far too long, so let's go ahead and get right back into the game, and I'm gonna shut up.
This is outrageous. We're loyal citizens.
How long do we have to wait? What am I supposed to do? Just sit here and let everything spoil?
Watch out for the Osiron merchants. They're assumed cheap.
I thought Meridian was open to all Karja.
What happened to Ursa has nothing to do with us.
All right, guys, so we made it to Meridian, but what the heck is going on here? Sounds like there's some anger.
If I don't get my goods to buyers soon, they'll cancel the contract.
What's going on here? Olin's in there, somewhere. And so's Erend, that other outlander I talked to the night before the proving. Erend said he'd introduce me to his sister if I visited Meridian. Said she was captain of the Vanguard.
So it sounds like there is some trouble in Meridian. I know, what a surprise. Ooh, come on, guys. Don't block my path. Alright, so it sounds like they're not letting people through. So I have to do something.
Stop right there. In light of the recent attack, no stranger passes into Meridian without submitting to search.
Recent attack? What are you talking about?
The murder of Captain Ursa and her vanguards, of course. Ambushed by Shadow Karja forces in Redridge Pass.
Ursa? You mean Erend's sister is dead?
How would you know his name?
I know Erend. Summon him. I need to speak to him.
Ha! Huh. I doubt that Erend, the new captain of the Vanguard, a man in grief, is going to waste his time on a grimy outlander.
Aloy! Hey, you're alive! I thought you were dead. Make way, make way!
All the way to Meridian, just to see me?
Have you been drinking?
Not really. A little. So, you're alive. This, we should celebrate. The drink's on me!
We need to talk, alone, and you need to pull it together.
Over there.
So you approve? Of course I approve. From now on, she may come and go from this city as she pleases.
As you wish, sir.
There. Alone as you asked. And what did you want to tell me?
A lot has happened since we last spoke. The proving was attacked by a group of killers. Not many of us survived.
We were in the village when we heard explosions up on the mountain. Some of your braves came back, said most of the contestants were dead. I've never heard such a wail of grief as the sound that rose up from your people. How did you survive?
How I survived is less important than how I was targeted.
Targeted? What do you mean?
The killers came for me because of Olin.
What are you talking about? That doesn't make sense.
I need to find Olin. I need to know what he knows.
But he's a friend.
No, he's a traitor. I don't know who the killers are or what they want, but I do know that Olin is working with them.
But, I mean, this...
I don't need you to understand, Erend. I just need you to take me to him.
He's not here. He went scrounging for scrap and relics days ago. It could be anywhere.
Are there any places he frequents? Places he returns to?
A house. Here in Meridian.
Okay, then take me there. I need to search it.
I guess. As long as I'm there to witness the search.
I heard what happened to Ursa. I'm sorry. I know she was special to you.
Special to me? Special to everyone. She always knew what to do. She bossed everyone around. She kept me in line. Now I'm supposed to fill her shoes. And instead, here I am, stumbling around in them.
I I lost someone too. At the Proving, the man who raised me. His name was Rost.
That's terrible. Why is it every time something terrible happens, everyone else tells you the worst thing that ever happened to them, as though that makes it easier?
Yeah, why is that?
Anyway, there is something you wanted to tell me?
I need to see Olin's place. Now.
Okay. Come on.
So that was probably the wrong choice. I was just trying to connect.
So many people here, all talking at once. How does anyone think?
I don't. I just drink.
I didn't trust him before. I don't know. Maybe he's not so bad.
That must be the spire.
That girl. It's huge. Nora? Apparently they're letting anyone into the city these days.
Jeez.
Vengeance for Ursa! How long will Abad hide in his palace? Blood for blood. Vengeance for Ursa. How long will Abad hide in his palace?
Year after year, why does he spare those who enslaved and tortured and butchered? Erend, you should want vengeance more than anyone. Your own sister, murdered. And her death, unavenged?
One more word, you scorched out slag, and I'll throw you in jail myself! Now get out of here, or I'll give you all a kick in the ass!
Jeez.
What did he mean about Ursa's murder?
Not now.
That merchant's got a star in it. I wonder if it's special. No wonder Aaron's drinking.
Okay, how are we gonna get in? Oh, that was subtle.
Here we are. Try not to break anything. Other than the door.
All of this for one man.
It pays to have connections in the Sun King's court.
This road is frayed. The floor near it is worn. Let's see what's underneath.
Hey, how did that get here?
Question is, how to get through it?
Without a key, you won't. That's a vault hatch of Azaram make. Nothing gets through.
We'll see about that.
Okay. Somebody over there. Let's go ahead and go upstairs.
Call it a day, girl. You're wasting time.
Really? Because I just found a hatch.
It looks like a picture of Olin's family. It looks like a picture of Olin's family.
That's it. It says examine. Okay. Something over here.
A lot of metal here. Could be just what I need.
Okay, are we gonna push this?
Looks big and heavy. Could do a lot of damage if it fell down. Let's give it a little push.
I did say not to break anything, didn't I?
Oh, come on, that was fantastic. Oh, he's already down here. I was like, wait, how do we get a person in here? Owen's journal. A map. Ooh, here, what's this?
Serve and they live. Disobey and I will open their throats and leave their corpses to prune in the sun.
They took his wife and child captive.
They? Who's they?
The killers. They told him to obey or they'd kill his family.
Jeez. All right, feeling a little bad for Olin now.
The map. The glyphs show places he visited. Looks like Olin kept a journal.
Olin? I knew he could read contracts, but I never took him for a poet.
No doubt now. Olin knew I was targeted.
Well, there we
go. There's proof. Read the last page. He writes about meeting me and the order to kill me.
He called himself a friend. That backstabbing cheat. How did you learn to read glyphs? And these things that you see, how do you do it?
The focus. It reveals the unseen.
And Olin's focus, it's the same?
The device is the same, but somehow Olin and the killers can speak to each other with their focuses over distances. And see through each other's focuses, too. Like looking through each other's eyes.
So that's how the killers saw you. Through Olin.
Yes, so far as I can tell. Now that I know where to find Olin, I should be on my way.
All by yourself?
Leave it to me. I'm faster on my own.
Wait. If that device lets you see the unseen...
Out of the way, Erend.
I'm asking you to help me, Aloy. I need to know who killed Ursa. Not just the Shadow Carja army, I know that, but the exact soldiers who did it.
I'm sorry about your sister, but that's your war, not mine.
Don't act like this isn't personal. You came here hunting the people who nearly killed you, who massacred your people. Why should you have justice and not me? Look, I'll head for Red Ridge Pass, where Ursa's body was found, and wait for you there. A few minutes of your focus is all I need. Don't make me beg.
Red Ridge Pass, you said? I'll see what I can do.
Damn right, girl, you know we're gonna go there. He's been nothing but nice to you. Okay, yeah, I didn't trust him at first. But he's our buddy now. Alright, guys, we're gonna check out these exclamation marks, see what people have to ask us. Hello, good sir.
This place smells like nothing I've ever smelled before. Is that some kind of spice?
You're an outlander. Nora, from the look of you. I'll bet you're a machine hunter, too.
I've hunted my share.
Well, let me give you a word of advice. Don't bother with the Hunter's Lodge. If you're not Carja, you'll never rise in the ranks.
I see.
What's wrong with the hunting lodge, exactly?
Nothing, if you like stuck-up bigots. I'm known as a skilled hunter back home in Banur, so I thought I'd try my luck at the lodge. I thought it'd be simple. Hunt machines, gain ranks, see who's best. But it doesn't work like that at all. It's all rigged to keep the Carja at the head of the line. I don't need those snobs to tell me I can hunt. I'm going home.
Are you saying that you have to be Carja to join the lodge?
No. They take other tribes, but they have rules in place to keep outlanders from gaining ranks. When Sun King Avad took over, he promised the new day, Meridian, open to all. But it's a sham. Sure, you can get a seat at the feast, but you just can't eat the food.
Sounds like someone needs to shank things up at the lodge.
Maybe, but it isn't gonna be me. If you decide to go, be sure to give them a good old-fashioned Banuk farewell mark in my honor.
A Banuk farewell mark. What's that?
Piss on the floor. Preferably someplace they won't find it until it gets nice and sour.
No, thank you. I will not be doing that. Oh, shit. All right, so we got quite a few more. Okay, that's 26. Let's just go right over here. I can see this guy.
You there! Can you help me?
You there!
You're the one the Vanguard has been crowing about. The Nora who tracks criminals and traitors with her second sight. If only you'd use it to help me. A thief raided my home and took my brother's sword.
Tell me about the robbery. Don't leave anything out.
It was brazen and professional. They took only the sword, my most valuable possession. The thief went out through the window and scared the shadow off my steward. Otherwise, it would have been a clean getaway.
Why would someone steal the sword?
It's priceless. Made from the burnished antler of a lancehorn, finely inlaid with studded stones all down the...
Okay, I get it.
Forgive me. That's not even why it's important. The 12th Sun King gave it to my brother for his military service. He was killed in battle during the liberation. I was saving it for my nephew who stranded at Sunfall with the Karja in Shadow.
How did your nephew wind up in Sunfall?
Most of the old clergy backed the Mad Sun King, so when he fell, they ran out of fear of retribution. As an honor guard to a venerable priest, my nephew had no choice but to go with them. Now that my brother is gone, my nephew is my heir, so that sword really belongs to him. And after all he's been through, I won't be able to look him in the face if I don't get it back.
I'll see what I can do about the robbery.
Have a word with my steward if you need to. He saw the thief escape. And listen, all I want is the sword back. Meridian, and my family for that matter, has seen enough strife already. If I can get it back, all is forgiven. No retribution necessary.
I don't know, I'd want some damn retribution. Alright, so... we'll need to talk to his steward. I'm gonna raid this real quick. Let's go ahead and talk to his steward since we're already here.
You saw the thief make a run for it?
My back was to the wall, you see. Wasn't expecting someone to crawl out the window. He ran past me, dressed in gray, clutching the sword. That's all I saw. By the sun, my heart nearly seized up.
Okay. So that's a big bunch of nothing. So see, there's a regular merchant, and then there's one with stars on it. So we're gonna go find this other exclamation point, and then we'll check out the merchants. Because if there's some cool stuff I don't have yet, you damn well know I'm gonna be getting it. Okay, looks like they're probably down here. I don't know if I need to light fires to visit them in the future or not, but it seems worth it. Oh. Okay. Well, I gotta go up. Let's try this again.
Maybe once Sunfall surrenders, Meridian will feel whole again.
Nope, that's the exact same place I just was. I'm gonna have to cut this out. Because I can't find where I'm going. I'm gonna have to cut this out. Oh, there we go.
Corruption strikes.
Able-bodied adventurers, preferably with no friends or family, but I'm not choosy.
That sounds weird.
Oi there, Outlander. Name's Vilgund. Did you come to the city looking for work? Oh, good shards. Enough to buy garb more becoming of your...
Okay, stop there if you want me to hear you out.
I only meant a well-molded woman such as you. I heard an interesting rumor about a Banuk camp. Tame machines, the rumor said. So I hired men to investigate. Just investigate, that's all. Those Banuk are canny, too canny. I paid up front. Well, half up front. I've had no word back.
So now you're hiring someone to find the last men you hired.
They're a sunk cost. This rumor's worth more to me.
So is there any more to the rumor about this camp?
The last bunch just wanted to know about the reward. Hey, you're a smart one. This camp isn't even big enough for a name up where the snow won't thaw. They say the Banuk there live alongside machines. Peaceful as you like. Keep them, use them, sing to them. If it's true, if we learn how they do it, think how valuable that would be to all the tribes.
When you say valuable, you mean they'd pay you for it.
Girl, I'm not made of straw.
What can you tell me about the Banuk?
The Banuk women, snow witches all. Cold eyes, cold... They choose to live up there in Ban-Ur, in the ice. Trying to have a conversation, it's like chipping them out of the stuff. They prefer machines for company. That's why I'm putting my shards on this rumor.
Then they might not want outsiders to know about this place.
Their mystic act. No care for possessions, for luxuries. Pile of slag. Those people bargain harder than the winter frost.
Are you some kind of merchant? You don't seem to have any wares.
More of an explorer.
But you send other people to do your exploring.
All right. More of an opportunist. Girl. Nora, girl. Huntress. We live in a world of opportunities. Risky opportunities. But why should risk stand in the way of a lucrative prospect for the likes of me? All right. I'm more of a gambler.
If I did look into your rumor...
You won't need to climb up the shoulders of the world for it. It's on the edge of Banuk land, beneath the anvil of the moon. And you look like you know your way around the savage east. The east. If it's true they walk among machines without fear in this camp, well, you can't miss that, can you? Payment on return.
All right. All right. So we still have one more exclamation mark. Let's go ahead and see if we can find this one. I'm guessing it's up here. Let's see. There we go. Gosh, so many people want our help here.
Ronora. I'm the mournful Naman. My apologies that we meet like this.
Like this?
In grief. You hold yours close, like a talisman. Wait, forgive me. You didn't come for reparations? Someone you lost to the Sun Ring?
Oh, no. I know about the Red Raids, but the Karja owe me nothing.
I see. Well, I could use the help of a strong-willed outlander. Then I would owe you very much indeed. These people seek to honor their loved, their lost, with their own voices, not mouthing Karja rituals to Karja stone. But there are obstacles. While Meridian holds its breath for any disturbance, these robes only tie my hands.
What kind of obstacles?
The first pilgrim is an Oseram who seeks to visit the Shrine of Kings on the road to the city. He waits there now, forbidden to enter by an old sun priest who suffer no heathen. This Utaru lost her companion on the edge of the jewel, at a pool where snap moths gather. The shrine was built there to ward off the machines, and its effectiveness leaves much to be desired. And the Manuk would paint a mark on the sun's climb. Call to the machine spirits, I understand. They need no beckoning. Glinthawks perch there, drawn to the spire's shining.
So clear the machines out of two shrines and move a priest out of the other.
All I can ask for is your charity and that their stories are heard.
Naman, rituals and prayers can't bring back those who are lost.
No, but it can help those who grieve to find themselves. It can lend them strength and hope, like a new sunrise.
I didn't think your priesthood would ask outsiders for help.
If only the sun would set on our pride. Until this is done, I am no sun priest. To wear a red robe was an aspiration. I aspired. Now our hoods make us blind. We whisper reconciliation, but forget how the old king's priests sang the words and blessed the killing.
The killing? You mean the Red Raids?
Yes. And the sacrifices that came after.
Why did the priests go along with all that bloodshed?
Sometimes we Karja are more concerned with what is tradition than what is right.
Huh. Maybe the Karja and Nora aren't so different. You're disappointed with the Sun Priests, but you still wanted to be one?
I spent my whole life looking up to the temple. My brother's voice echoing in his arches. Even he couldn't turn me away, and how he tried in the end. He said, when we were loved, our robes were dyed in cinnabar. Now they are stained in blood.
How so?
Our robes are handed down to us. Most of the old priests fled rather than be seen in the glare of a new sun. And so we are left to wear their sins. For me, at least, they hang heavy.
Where is your brother now?
He waits for me on the trail of the sun, I hope. He spoke out against the sacrifices. For a priest to question the Sun King's will, his punishment was worst of all.
You lost someone you loved, too. I'm sorry.
No, not lost. When I took on these robes, I found his memory.
I'll do what I can to help those in mourning.
To honor their memories is to honor us all.
Alright, guys. I said I was gonna run back there. You know what? Alright, guys. I was walking around. Gonna go back to that merchant, and I saw this. Let's see. Alright, so as usual, guys, pause if you want to read it. Go ahead and just go through real quick. We're gonna go back to that merchant that has a star over its head. I'm hoping that's one of the rare things you can buy. I have a couple. The purple stuff is the rare stuff you can buy. And I'm hoping that they're going to have some more of that stuff, because I have got some amazing weapons. Oh, there's more than one? Wait, no. No, this is the one. Okay. Why would I... Alright, guys, so I got in here. I don't know why I'd buy any of this stuff. Most eclectic merchants? This stuff means nothing to me. I don't know why I'd buy any of this. I'm a little surprised. Dirty basket? Like, what am I gonna use a dirty basket for? Okay, so I thought that maybe they had some rare items, but turns out not. So we're gonna go ahead and walk away from that one.
Found any relics in the wilds, Outlander?
You're looking for artifacts.
Yes, but I'm no profiteer. Sun King Avad has named me an envoy to the Banuk. I work on their behalf, looking for sacred relics to return to their homeland, Ben-Ur. I'm especially interested in wooden figures that are sometimes found near Banuk rock paintings. If you have any, I have valuables to trade for them.
You said the king named you an envoy to the Banuk?
Yes. I've been to Ben-Ur many times, and the Wirik chiefs trust me. I help them maintain diplomatic ties with Avad. Some say they're a mysterious people, but their ways make a lot of sense to me. All you have to do is be the best. Doesn't matter if you're born high or low, man or woman. They respect skill, not some fool notion of heritage.
I see the appeal.
I wish more Karja did. Anything they don't understand, they call backward or savage.
Tell me more about these Banuk figures.
Simple wood sculptures, made by Arna, a legendary hunter who was exiled from Ban-Ur for killing his chief. He left the figures near painted stones in places that reminded him of his homeland. Later, his tribe declared him innocent. Now they see him as a kind of wandering hero and want those figures back. I do what I can to help him get them, including trade for them, if you have any. You ready? Let's trade then.
All right, guys, so I did off screen. I actually picked up a couple of those Banuk figures. So let's go ahead. I'll sell those off. And I will be right back, guys. Alright, guys, so I currently have two of the artifacts. So it looks like if you turn in two, you can get this box. Let's go ahead and get it. Let's see. Oh, we can also get maps here. That's exactly what I want. I did this the last time. That worked out really well.
Come on back if you find any Banuk goods.
I'd like to discuss a trade with you, Outlander.
You already talked to me. So that's what's going on here. So there must be something. I wonder if I can sell. So I've been picking up a ton of those, like, cups, those drinking vessels. I wonder if I sell the drinking vessels to this person. So I'm gonna go ahead and find out. Alright guys, so I have been trying to show you guys my other two new merchants I discovered. Oop, wrong way. I do this every time. I tried to show you the other two merchants that I discovered. I actually did find out where we sell our cups, but unfortunately my PS4 has been giving me a hard time. So you're going to notice that I've already talked to these people, but I can still get their stories from you. So here we go.
Yes, I remember you. Did you find the vessels I seek?
So you're interested in the old ones?
More than interested. I study every ancient artifact I can get my hands on. But years of study have made me too comfortable at my desk. I can't even bear the sun, if the truth be known. I don't know how I'll manage to take a partner. My family presses me for an heir.
Don't look at me.
Oh, no, I'm not looking. In fact, my father already has someone he wants me to wed. She doesn't interest me. I wish I had a brother to carry this burden. I would rather be left to my precious little vessels.
What sort of ritual were these vessels made for?
I'm convinced they were used in conjunction with each other in sets. Some people believe they were used for tea ceremonies. Others think they held sacred essences and oils for worship. But I believe they were used for the solemn custom of shaving one's beard. One for water, one for lotion, and so on. Each fluid in its special vessel, majestically applied to the face at each stage of the rite. It must have been breathtaking. But which vessel was used for which? I have to know. I have to continue my research.
Are you sure people didn't just drink out of them?
Drink? Out of such finely crafted earthenware? Don't be ridiculous. Yes, trade quickly. I have work to do.
All right, guys, so here it is. So you can sell those basically mugs that I've been finding, but unfortunately you have to get them in very specific sets. So I'm missing one out of each of these sets, and I'm missing this entire set. So all that crazy running around I've been doing.
I will leave you to the hunt. Be sure to delve into the ruins. What do my tired
trying to clear
eyes
the map
see?
Actually worked out for me.
Sure.
So there's one more over here. He doesn't talk to you. At least I think it's this way. Nope, it is not this way. There's one more merchant that just sells specialty, like, gambling boxes, which are fun. You know, I've actually bought a fair bit of them. I'll go ahead and show you this guy. He doesn't talk to you none, though, so. But he sells all of those mystery boxes, so pretty cool. So I'm going to go ahead, guys. I'm going to transition back to Revenge. It's a Daughter's Revenge. That's the one we're going to be working on. So you can see here, we're in Meridian. So we're going to be traveling up here to Lonesome Rock. That was actually where we were on our way to when I actually stumbled across Meridian. And I was actually only coming here because I needed a campfire. So I will go ahead, guys. We should probably do some of those hunting videos, too. I'll do those a little bit later. We'll go ahead and do that. You know what? I take it all back. Alright guys, so since we're still in Meridian, let's go ahead and finish this crime scene investigation. Let's see, we're going this way? Alright, so let's finish our investigation.
The thief broke the lattice on the way out.
I've got all the best
blood.
Goods here.
Looks like they cut themselves into splinters. Drops of blood leading away.
Alright, so let's go find our thief. And then after that, we'll pick back up with a Daughter's Revenge.
More blood. I'm still on the trail.
Oop, I just ran myself right into a pillar. So if you don't remember, we're looking.
The thief got cut. The trail ends here.
We're looking. We're looking for a special sword.
At least you don't put on airs.
You can't ask that guy. Oh, here we go. Here's who I'm checking with.
Did someone run past here, holding a sword?
Sure did. He grabbed some linen off the stand here and took off down the stairs behind you. He
nephew's bleeding, so maybe he needed a binding. Blast it! That was expensive cloth. I can't believe I paid for that thief's bandage.
All right, so keep following.
All the best goods here. Take a look at these.
Wait.
Need, leave the rest.
Why in the heck can't I find the track?
Find goods for a fair price.
Why the heck can't I find the track? What the heck?
Won't cost you a charge.
Alright. I don't know why. I couldn't figure out where I was going. Alright, I need to go to the base of the stairs.
If the thief came this way, there's only one way he could have gone. Forward.
Let's see. So it looks like there's a person highlighted over here.
No sign of a thief. Someone must have seen him go by. Did you see anyone run through here? He would have been holding a sword.
Yeah. Almost crashed into me, too. He ran down the parapet here and went down the lift. No way he'll catch him now. I didn't see a sword, though.
He wasn't carrying anything.
Not a damn thing. Just ran like his ass was on fire.
The thief must have ditched the sword. But where? Maybe he had help. That merchant star would have been a convenient drop-off.
Alright. So I'm gonna return back to that merchant. At least it's not too far of a run back. Usually I cut all this stuff out, but I'd be cut in like seconds. Now let's find out. I bet you she's got it.
I've got all the best goods here.
It looks like the thief got away, but without the sword. I thought maybe he dropped it off somewhere. Like here, for instance?
What? No. I had nothing to do with this.
I guess we'll see when I get the city guard to toss your stall and question your customers.
Hold on. There's more to this. You've got a reputation for shining light in the darkness, so I know you'll listen. You're right. The sword was passed to me, and I passed it on to someone else. It's going to be sold, but not for profit. The shards will go to people in need.
You expect me to believe that?
I can prove it. Meet my friends at the watermill in the lower village. They'll explain everything. If they don't convince you, come right back with the guards. I'm not going anywhere.
It wouldn't matter if you did. I'd find you. But all right. I'll check out the watermill. Okay. Guess I should go to this watermill then to find out what's going on.
All right, guys. So we're headed off. Looks like the way we get down there is here. What the hell is this? You can't get down. Oh, okay. It's an elevator. Holy shit, look at that. I wonder if I can jump up on here. No? Nope. It's preventing me from killing myself. What about on the box? Just trying to get a better look. Looks like it was a golf course. Are we still waiting on this elevator? Come on. There we go. I probably could have walked down there in this time. Give me a giant ass set of stairs. Alright. Let's see. Pull this. So ordinarily I cut all this stuff out, but it looks like we're close. So I didn't want to cut in case there's some cool stuff. And it looks like, especially, I mean, this elevator is pretty cool. It also looks like we're about to maybe go to some other settlement areas? I don't know which way this is going to open. My guess is this way. Since over here it looks like brick. Alright. Oh, right off the bat we got some more, exclamation marks. Let's go ahead and, you know, we're already here. Let's go ahead and see what this guy wants.
Metalbot here. Good. Fairest prices for machine parts under the mesa. No tithes to the Sun Court. Not like those greedy snarls upside.
She's not interested in taxes.
I know what she's not interested in. As I was saying, no better offer for snap-ball lenses. I'd give my oath on it.
By the sun, don't start spitting in your palm. Huntress, I apologize on behalf of my partner. Silent partner.
Silent partner?
If the sun would only grant my prayers. Never mind snap more lenses, Huntress. There's no market for those. A long leg lens, though, you'd be well rewarded for.
So which...
No market for a snap-maw lens. It's good, strong stuff. You can hammer it into anything.
Where do you think we are? Some trading post with sawdust on the floor? This is Meridian. We have culture.
I know culture. Just the other day, I was watching the hunting trials.
Oh, great sun, lend me the strength of midday.
The sun's baked your head if you think we'll shift long-leg lenses at a time like this.
Hello?
I've told you as many times as the spire is tall, craft and artisanship is who we are.
Craft doesn't win a war or keep the machines from your farms. What you need is good old-fashioned plain...
Oh, yes. Old-fashioned plain hammered work. If ever something glittered, you'd throw it back.
If Karja had built that elevator, they would have stopped at a good-looking shaft.
All those years of delving, and you never found a sense of humor.
Enough!
Well?
They're a blunt people, the Nora.
Why do you two even work together if you can't agree on anything?
It's a symbolic gesture.
No tithes to the Sun Court, like I said in the beginning, Renine.
Just tell me which part you want.
A long leg lens.
A snap-maw lens.
Fine. I can see that you're busy.
Wait. You drove her off. Snap-maw lens. What do you say?
I drove her off? That's rich. Listen, Huntress. Long leg lens.
Hunters, scroungers, bring us your...
All right. Oh, let's see. I got both of them?
I brought you both the parts. So, what do you say?
I don't suppose I could buy just the one.
You'd buy the wrong one. So give the hunter her shards for both.
Of course. Here you are. If this is the price I have to pay.
The price you have to pay? The snap-maw lens might just cover the loss we take on the other.
It won't sell for a loss, charcoal burner. You'd pay handsomely for a long leg lens if you had an imagination.
I have an imagination. When you rattle that piece of junk around, I think of your skull.
This wouldn't be a scrap.
I like these guys. Okay, let's go ahead and I'm gonna avoid that other. Oh gosh, what's it called? Exclamation mark! I'm gonna go ahead and run to that mill. Why is the mill getting farther away? Okay. Sometimes the way this game works doesn't make any sense to me. Okay, here we go. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and cut. This is taking a lot longer than I thought it would. Alright guys, we're here. Let's check in with this guy.
I was told to expect you, Aloy. I suppose you want answers. Well, it's not complicated. We collect valuable objects from people who don't need them, sell them for shards, and use the money to help the needy at Sunfall.
You mean you steal?
If you want to call it that. From hogs who've had their turn at the trough for generations.
Ravon didn't seem like a hog to me.
He stinks just like the rest of them, of wealth and contentment, while people beneath him suffer.
Who exactly gets the shards at Sunfall?
Not the bastards in the fortress. We use the shards to make sure the poor in Shadowside get to eat or bandage their wounds. They only went west because they had to. Trust me, I know. My wife was chained up with a bunch of servants and herded with them. They starved to death, still bound together.
Oh. I'm sorry.
So am I.
Where's the sword now?
Safe. I haven't sold it yet.
What do you expect me to do now? Walk away?
I was hoping you'd help us. They say you can track like a stalker. Well, my partner, Nassan, disappeared near the branded shore. He was bound for Sunfall, along with an entire shipment of food. If you found that, you'd be helping a lot of people.
Well, consider it. But only if you return the sword to Ravon.
I knew you were gonna say that. Fine, I'll return the damn blade. Nassan was supposed to meet his contact at an old campfire on the fort near the branded shore. Start looking there. But be careful. Lots of machines out there, and lots of Shadow Karja. And not the needy kind, but they're tormentors.
Alright, guys. So looking at this one looks like it's pretty damn far away. So we're not actually going to work on this one right now. We're going to go ahead and continue on with a Daughter's Vengeance. Sorry, I forgot where I was going for a second. We're going to continue on with the Daughter's Vengeance. That's the one we really want to finish. So I will transition when we get back to Lonesome Rock.